Class 8. So in the last class I have explained the chapter, the chapter that is Getting Future Ready's first part, that is self-driving car. So today we will be discussing human robots. So before I start, what is robot? I would like to ask, what is robot? You know, robot is a machine, and especially one programmable by a computer and capable of carrying out a complex series of actions automatically. And robots can be guided by an external control device, or the control may be embedded within, right? So this is robot. And now the question is, what is humanoid robots? Because here in this chapter we will be discussing about a humanoid robot named Sophia. So humanoid robots is a robot with its body shape built to resemble the human body. It's very similar to a human body, and the design may be for functional purpose such as interacting with human tools and environment, or for experimental purposes such as the study of bipedal locomotions, or for other purposes. So in general, humanoid robots have a, you know, head, two arms, two legs like human, and though some forms of humanoid robots may model only part of the body. So these are the humanoid robots, and in this world there are so many humanoid robots are there, like Sophia is one of them, Erica is there. Okay, so here in this chapter, what is we will be discussing about a humanoid robot named Sophia. Let's start. Are robots all brain and no heart, all intelligence and no emotions? So here at the beginning of the text, the writer is asking some questions. Are robot all brain and no heart? So the writer is asking, so only robots are having brain, they are having no hearts, all intelligence, no emotions. Our robot can move its limbs in limited ways, but can it smile, laugh or cry? Well, Sophia is here to answer these questions and change the future of humanoids. So humanoids is a machine that look and behave like human. So the scientist, whoever had made Sophia, they have installed some human-like qualities in Sophia. They have put some emotions, like Sophia can feel the emotions. She can cry, she can laugh. See, Sophia is a social humanoid robot developed by Hanson Robotics, Hong Kong. So in Hong Kong there is a lab, robotic lab, where Sophia has made. And Sophia was developed by Hanson Robotics. She was activated on 14 February 2016 and revealed to the public in March 2016 in Austin, USA. So it was first activated, started its journey on 24th of February 2016, but officially it was published, you know, it was revealed to the public in March 2016, after 1 month. So in USA, Austin, Sophia can display more than 50 facial expressions. So she can, so her expressions, facial expression like smiling, crying, laughing, right, this kind of expressions, and imitate several human gestures and hold a simple conversation. And it can talk to the people, okay, and she has that ability and that functional abilities, and that has put into his internal machines, right? She has functional legs too and can walk like us, and she is having two legs and she can walk like human. And the use of Fraber is an elastic form of rubber invented by Hanson Robotics. So see, the use of rubber gives Sophia's face a lifelike appearance. So her face, her facial marks was made of rubber, one kind of elastic form of rubber, and it gives Sophia's face a human-like appearance. And computer algorithms and artificial intelligences. So now there are two terms: computer algorithms. What is computer algorithms? So in mathematics and computer science, an algorithm is a finite sequence of well-defined computer implementable instructions, typically to solve a class of problems or to perform a computations, right? So this is computer algorithms. This is a mathematical form to and its purpose is to solve a class of problems. And now artificial intelligence, AI. In computer science, artificial intelligence, something called machine intelligence. And it is one kind of intelligence demonstrated by machines, and in contrast to the natural intelligence displayed by human and animals, right? This is a, you know, bridge between human and machine, this artificial intelligence, right? So computer algorithms and artificial intelligence allow her to recognize faces and voices, maintain eye contact, and process human speech. So Sophia is having two scientific, you know, two software, like that is computer algorithms and artificial intelligence, and that made him to allow her face to recognize faces, voices, and maintain eyes contacts and process of human speech. These two, you know, two things made him to do and maintain and process like a human speech. And Sophia was conceptualized by David Hanson as a companion for the elderly in nursing homes, as a guide at large public place and events. Conceptualized means originally designed by. So Sophia was originally designed by the David Hanson as a companion for the elderly nursing homes. So Sophia is developed because to use in nursing homes, elderly nursing homes, and as a guide, and she can be used as a used as at large public places and events, right? Nowadays you can see some hospitals, some nursing homes, some COVID special nursing homes are using robots, right, to consult a COVID patient, such like. And Sophia was made for this purpose, right? And Sophia is the United Nations Development Program's first ever innovations champion. So Sophia, these robots, these humanoid robots, had won the, you know, United Nations Development Program's first innovations champions award. As of now, Sophia can only answer specific questions based on predefined topics, but her range is expected to improve with further research. So Sophia is having some limitations. She can only give some answer of some predefined questions that is inbuilt in her system. and but her range is expected to improve, but there is a chance that the scientists they can improve her range. Okay, and the scientists can upgrade the software, right, with further research. Sophia's popularity indicates that there will be more functional humanoids, and Sophia became so famous around the world. Now the writer is expecting that there will be more functional humanoids in future, that we might have got or we might get many more humanoid robots or functional humanoids in future, and that elements of science fiction may one day become a reality. And there we can, and in future, we may find that some humanoid robots, they are walking like us in the road, on the road, and they are walking, they will work in the office, they will teach as a teacher in the school in future, right? So this is all about Sophia. And in page number 35, tick the correct options. Please read the text and do the exercise. Tick the correct options. 1, 2, 3. Okay. And please read the PDF. Thank you.